Hello again, and welcome back to the card mat. Yes, a nice, good magician fooling move this, and it is. We'll demonstrate it. We'll use the King of Spades to demonstrate it with. Now, watch carefully, right? And see what you think's going on, right? As that goes into there, and then we do that, and we do that. Yeah, now in your minds there's, well, I don't know what's actually in your minds, but you know what I mean, there's something. And then if I try and do this, where you do one of these cuts like that, now honestly be honest with yourselves as well as me, if you've seen a magician doing that, knowing what you know, where would you think that card ended up at the end? Down there, wouldn't you? But it isn't, because it's actually ended up there. Yeah, see, magician fooler, you're doing a false triple, a false trinity cut, but yet you somehow moved the bottom card to the bloody top. It's clever. I have done this one a while ago, but it's such a nice move and such a good convincer, I thought I'd show you it again. And so I'll show you it again, a little bit slower, so you can see what's going on. And again, we'll use the King of Spades. The King of Spades goes into the middle. You push in, you catch your break. You do your double undercut. Now, any magician watching you would know it's only in one or two places, either the top or the bottom. You just give a little flash. They now know it's on the bottom. So they're going to be watching. Before you do your cut, just get a pinky pull down. I find it easier this way. Just get a pinky pull down on your bottom card and keep a break. Transfer that into a thumb break as you cut the top part across. Break this up, and as you come across, you're just depositing that card onto the top as that packet goes through. As you spin that one and drop them on the top to get the king back to the top again. And as I say, they're going to think it's on the bottom, so they're going to be watching for anything that goes on the bottom, aren't they? Yeah, they are. So let's see, where could you go from here? Yeah, from here you could do something like, so if we take this card, just a random card, that four of clubs, and we just stick that on the table there for a minute, right? Now we want to see if we can find your card in this package, so I'll just riffle, and anytime you like, you say stop. So then you riffle, and then you do one of them, and you go, right, well, we'll take that one, but we won't throw it down. We'll keep that up here, like that. So we hope to have found your card, right? But I didn't tell you that that four of clubs is a bit magic. If I just wave them over the top like that, we find that the four of clubs actually jumps up into the packet and dropped your card down here on the table. Now, they wouldn't be expecting that, because they thought that king was on the bottom, and they've seen nothing happening from the bottom. So they'd have no idea where the hell you got your king from, basically. I say, very nice move. It goes in and you do what you need to do just to get it down to the bottom. Give a flash to show it's on the bottom. Oh, I forgot my break. Catch a little pinky break, turn it into a thumb break, split the top half off. As that comes across, as it's coming across, you can use this little finger to get into that break just to pull that card down. So when you spin it around, it ends up a lot squarer on the packet for when you put down. And again, they think it's on the bottom, but yeah, hey, it's on the top. Give it a try. It's not that hard. And it's, as I say, it's a magician fooler. It is, because you'll throw them off the track. Have fun with it, guys, and I'll see you again soon. Well, that was a quick one, wasn't it? I made up with that.